Bayou Brawler, the American Alligator. Been a star in Big B's Bayou Buddies stunt show, but our shark is far too young to appreciate Rosie's classic brand of celebrity. Random mutations aren't random. They require large amounts of mutagens as a catalyst. Any panic from the shark's target is felt. Protein caches like this one are a convenient and tasty way for sharks to increase their protein intake. In spite of their reputations as wrestlers, alligators haven't mastered the nuances of scientific holds like the figure four. Destruction of natural coastal habitats is sometimes necessary to build vacation homes for private equity fund partners. Back aboard the Cajun Queen, family tensions are at an all-time high.
Kyle, what's wrong? Can't you catch no reef?
I can, but this one's like 20 feet.
15.
Whatever.
Can't do it.
I'll come out there, I'll do it. The old man with one hand.
Yeah, well, maybe you shouldn't be mutilating baby sharks.
What you say?
Nothing.
Boy couldn't catch in a diaper. He telling me how to honor shark. Believe that?
I mean, I came down here thinking it'd be a good opportunity for some father-son bonding. But now, I don't know. I might start looking for another summer job.
Hey, not everybody made to be a fisherman. I just hope this whole university thing works out for him, yeah?
Sapphire Bay's famous Pier 1 provides visitors with plenty of skee ball, popcorn shrimp, and elegantly airbrushed t-shirts.
Ah!
The shark uses lipids from high-fat fare like this to help fuel her reign of terror. Some sharks are scavengers, indiscriminately consuming anything that's vaguely edible. Predatory scavenger is often quite content to dine on whatever wastes fall to the ocean floor. Goaded by lusty appetites, the shark's sole aim is to eat and evolve. The appetite of this shark is nearly insatiable. Sometimes even sharks just need to dirty bulk. The shark is known to be a voracious and hardly discriminating eater. The shark hears the faint, distant sound of a dinner call. Haven for small government ideologues, Port Clovis prides itself in its lax amusement park safety standards. Sharks' propensity to clear the ocean of its assorted detritus is one of their most valuable functions. Bull retreats to the grotto for refuge and quiet reflection. As is well known, volleyballs make way better friends than soccer balls, who will stab you in the back the first chance they get. The shark is a sort of super scavenger, completely lacking in what may be called dietary discrimination. America's largest shark finning enterprise, Mama Maybelle Bryant has collected quite a fleet of recreational boats. Her fail sons, Randall and Tyson, can often be spotted piloting them around Sapphire Bay. If only someone had done their sixth grade reading assignment, perhaps this tragedy could have been avoided. Bull sharks have a habit of gobbling up anything that finds its way into the water. Shark demonstrates the importance of getting enough minerals in her diet. Bull shark is an animal of broad dietary proclivities. Believe it or not, people paid over $12,000 to sleep in these tents and listen to Swedish DJs for an entire weekend. peace of the grotto enables the shark to approach the world with greater confidence and effectiveness. Eliminating weaker specimens, the shark is strengthening the herd. Ecosystems on the planet. Sharks naturally gravitate to areas where food is available and abundant. Bizarre-shaped head makes it easily identifiable. Parrotfish here have kept Sapphire Bay's local hammerhead healthy and strange looking. surveys the scene with cold, unfeeling eyes. Body weight by 1 million times, often because it's not checking food levels for ingredients like corn syrup and hydrogenated oil. The rapacious rover is always swimming, searching for anything to satisfy the gluttony that is their defining trait. Pride in boat ownership manifests itself in a variety of ways here in Port Clovis. This instantized protein makes a great between-meal supplement, giving the shark the energy she needs to put on serious mass. Traveling around, we are constantly reminded of how man's intrusion has disrupted the fragile equilibrium of the marine world. Golden Shore's development was originally met with local protest, but those objections were easily circumvented with campaign donations to Planning Commission Director Steve Traeger. Tigaroos are part of a complete balanced breakfast for anyone aspiring to one day suffer from fatty liver disease. Once more, the shark turns back to this place of centered calm. There's no such thing as a recession-proof business, except for the frozen banana stand. Whether boom or bust, the demand for reliable, quality frozen bananas remains a constant. And even the shark is transported to that bikini mandatory mindset.
Come on.
Another danger on the water for shark hunters? Determined buses searches. Their boats laden with evidence. Affidavits. The fishing phenom, Candyman Curtis. Despite Port Clovis's best efforts, the aquatic beast refuses to be tamed. Powers of society have retaliated with deterrent action, but mankind is ultimately impotent to stop Mother Nature's vengeance.
Nothing but an itty-bitty boy. The fact that he was afraid of that Ferris wheel should have told me he wasn't never gonna be no shark hunter.
Port Clovis has grown bored of the hunt, leaving our shark to fight another day.
It's a shark. How hard can it be to find? Well, how good I am at spotting stuff.
While homeless and itinerant, hobos will work for a living. They are not to be confused with bums, who are sedentary and refuse to work. And my son Jeff.
Well, that kind of sucks.
Humans' attention spans are short. They've already forgotten about the shark and her many crimes, so thus ends the bounty.
Shark's appetite is never satiated.